what inspired this film and for you specifically playing six roles? That's amazing. Yeah, tell me a little bit about that.
Well, it was definitely a tall order because I'd never directed anything before. But thank you. Yeah, but I'd had this character in my repertoire a long, long time. I love playing her. She's got a really good interior life, and she's challenging too. And I just thought she was a voice that needed to be heard. She's an LGBT character, and she's a lot about taking risks and owning your truth. And to me, that's important to me, and it resonates with me. So I wanted to share it with the world, and it felt great to get her out. You know.
Awesome. And tell me a little bit, like, in terms of an LGBT film, and I am an LGBT filmmaker myself, but in terms of, like, the future of women in film, how do you think, like, the Me Too movement has kind of opened the door for new voices and kind of, you know, where do you hope this film will go, or the series?
I'd love to get this series made because Trisha, who's the lead in this particular pilot, is just one of many characters, and they all have a common through line. They all lead double lives. They all struggle with their own respective truths until they eventually embrace it. But I think in terms of the Me Too movement, you're seeing this really exciting wave of female filmmakers that are emerging and getting recognition and getting noticed, and it's like so overdue, of course, you know, and I hope it just gets better, and not just for women, but for minorities, obviously, people of all kind, and just to hear different voices, you know, not just hear sort of the patriarchal, not that all art is like that, but white man's story. So
very cool. And tell me a little bit about your writing process. Like, what was that like? And
yeah, well, I adapted this from a feature I wrote, and it was sometimes kind of arduous and difficult. Lot of rewriting, lot of fine-tuning. My brother, who's a working writer-director, I would go to him and say, look at this draft. We'd go over notes, take it home, rework it. And the thing is, you can't really wait for the inspiration. You sort of just have to write, in my experience, and it starts to come. But sometimes, you know, if you're a filmmaker, it's really hard. Sometimes you're like, I'm hitting a block, and am I going to get past it, you know? So, yeah.
And just in terms of, I was interested in the Catholicism aspect. I was just wondering what inspired you to focus on Catholicism and everything in the film?
Well, I don't want to make a blanket statement about any religion, but I really wanted to show the contrast between her inner life and her very personal life and the life that she was sort of parading around or had grown up with. And, you know, to be honest, I mean, I think I know in my experience, I've known people who have grown up fiercely Catholic and or fiercely under the Christian umbrella, and they were gay. And it was, and in some cases, still really hard for their families to reconcile. And it's not to say all Catholics are going to feel that way, but it certainly exists. And I think also it still exists in 2019, even though you think, oh, we're more progressive now. It's not everybody is accepting.
Absolutely. I think that's a really good point. And I really appreciate that you brought that to the forum and to the table for conversation, because I think, like what you're saying, it is definitely still on people's minds and still a lingering issue for a lot of people.
I think so, yeah.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Kate.
It was your time. Nice to meet you.